I would like to address the owners of some English clubs. Gentlemen, you made a huge mistake. Some will say it is greed, others disdain, arrogance, flippancy, or complete ignorance of England's football culture. But actually, it doesn't matter. What matters is that there is still time to change your mind. Everyone makes mistakes. English fans deserve to have you correct your mistake. They deserve respect. This crisis will make us stronger and will make football stronger than ever, because the authorities have finally understood how important football is for European society. This crisis has proved once and for all that football is embedded in our society's DNA. It is part of our continent's history and our collective memories. It has been one of its greatest success stories for more than a century. Over the last year, as a direct result of the health situation, there have been virtually no disciplinary incidents on the stands. There have, however, been abuses both on the pitch and on the social media. This is unacceptable and needs to be stopped with the help of the public authorities and the social media giants. Allowing a culture of hatred to grow with impunity is dangerous, my friends. Very dangerous, not only for football, but for society as a whole. Trace, identify, and isolate. This is the health strategy that many countries have adopted to limit the spread of the coronavirus. Trace, identify, isolate, and punish. This is the strategy that authorities should adopt in order to stamp out the virus of hatred on social networks.